emotional lately, like just thinking about this day. So I want to share a little speech slash thing I wrote, and it is titled, "Everyone is Capable of Success." When I first stepped foot into kindergarten, I was very shy and afraid. All the new objects and colors, as well as the amount of kids, filled my tiny 4-year-old self with fascination as well as fear. I remember clutching onto my mother's leg for dear life because I didn't want to feel alone. As I got a little older, I started to get used to these surroundings, but still had many troubles as more and more new surroundings and environments came my way. I had my outlets as well. Fifth grade, I got on stage with other kids who were in choir and sang in front of hundreds of teachers, parents, students, and students. When I least expected it, the music teacher for fifth grade had announced through the microphone that I had made it to the All-Stars Choir. I remember being surprised while my mother and my little brother clapped loudly and cheering in the crowd and many others. I won't forget the smile that didn't leave my face until I went to sleep that night. Middle school came along quickly, and that was when I just started to discover myself and my interest. Drawing was something that I counted on every day and absolutely loved and still love. The way that I used on the paper in many different colors fascinated me. Middle school was definitely tougher for me, though. There were also new surroundings and new students everywhere, and like almost every kid in school, I was heavily subjected to bullying and harassment. As eighth grade rolled around, I started to recognize how angry I felt towards myself and others. That's when things started going down even more. The moving of schools and multiple hospitalizations have affected me greatly. When I graduated middle school, I felt extremely accomplished, but I also felt like I didn't deserve it or deserve the recognition I received. The first day of freshman year in high school, I'll admit I was very scared. I was not ready for another step in my life at all. It scared me just knowing I was already a freshman in high school. As I reached sophomore year, things were starting to turn around. I had moved from an alternative school to my mother's school, which was Bristol Second. I had made honors once or twice that year and was very pleased with myself. Junior year had approached quickly, and things started to go bogus once again. A sequence of events have rattled my mind and made me once again angry and very uncaring of my friends. On February 9, 2018, I had lost someone who had and still has a major impact on my life, as well as my family's life, my grandfather. His passing was the cause of my major fall in junior year. March rolled around, and I had taken a couple tours of some schools that would better be a better fit for me. One of those schools was this school, Manchester Clay School. I remember the day of my interview for the school, and I could already tell that this school would benefit me in many ways. I was accepted to start school here in mid-March of 2018. I started to see that I was making great progress. My grades were going up, I felt less stressed and overwhelmed, and the teachers were very understanding and kind to me. Senior year started off rough, but I couldn't believe I was already a senior. Even though I had many lumps in the road this year, I still managed to keep high honors all year. And when I thought I couldn't handle the CWE program, I managed to work through it and had a great experience with it as well. It has been a long 12 years for me, and I never thought I would make it to this day, but I did. And I made it. I wouldn't have been able to make it if it wasn't for all the wonderful teachers and staff, as well as the students. I also wouldn't have been able to make it through school in general if it wasn't for my mother. She has had my back the longest I could remember, and I wouldn't know what I would do if I didn't have a mother with her. Another thing I have to say is don't give up. Even when someone tells you you aren't capable or that you can't, when everything feels like it's falling apart in the palm of your hands, do not give up. Keep pushing through. Things do get better with time and patience. Everyone is capable of success, and there are no excuses.